The next kind of pathogen are the fungi. Again, not all fungi are pathogenic, but here are a few. There are the yeasts, which can cause yeast infections, athlete's foot. Both of these kinds of fungi are going to be microscopic. And then we have the macroscopic, something like the very, very poisonous mushrooms. The common name for this one is the death cap, and just a few bites of this mushroom can kill you. The reason for this is they are feeding just the same way that the bacteria are. Fungi, remember, are heterotrophs. They have to feed on other things to get their energy. And since they don't have a mouth, they can't get up and walk around and follow things. They need to exude exoenzymes. And some of those exoenzymes make mushrooms taste really yummy. And some of those exoenzymes are highly toxic. Some mushrooms can actually kill people. This is what yeast actually looks like, a little single-celled organism living in this colony. It grows these little parts called hyphae, and they're a little bit like roots, but they grow down into tissue. And this is part of what makes fungi so difficult to fight. You can see a little bit of it on the outside of your skin, perhaps, but you can't get to the part that's down in the tissues. And anyone who's had athlete's foot knows that sometimes that takes a little while to fight because once fungi gets hold of a tissue, it's hard to get rid of. There are also protozoans that are pathogens. Here's two examples. The organism that causes malaria is a protozoan, and the organism that causes giardia, often known as the backpacker's disease, comes from a protozoan. These are single-celled eukaryotic organisms. They're almost always found in water, although the plasmodium is found in blood, so some sort of liquid. These are going to be cells that basically consume and kill our cells. They often have very complex life cycles, so they'll send part of their life in another organism and then part of their life in our body or in some kind of mammal. Here's an example of the life cycle of one where it's got a cyst stage and it can stay in this cyst stage dried out for 10 years. Once it gets into a nice warm intestine, it's going to develop into its reproductive form. It's going to cause disease. It's going to leave the system and get on to food again. Protozoan diseases are more associated with less developed countries where sanitation isn't as guaranteed and you're more likely to have feces come in contact with water and food items. Finally, there's a whole group of worms that can cause disease. And worms do some interesting things. This is not an earthworm. These are the kind of worms that you would get, like a tapeworm, internal roundworms. They're going to compete with our cells for nutrients, and they also give off different chemicals that depress our immune system. So you can get a worm infection, and your immune system doesn't respond the way it does to some of the other pathogens. Again, worms are a fairly easy group to fight off. You can see here we have the different kinds of worms with diseases, and how do we deal with them? Vaccines, drugs, it's fairly easy. So worms tend to be the biggest issue in places where it's hard to get vaccines or drugs to people. And so again, mostly developing countries have these kinds of diseases. They're less common here in the United States. Now, there's an interesting relationship here. There are some biologists who believe the greater incidence of allergies, food allergies, and other kinds of immune issues that we have now with many, many kids may be related to the fact that we don't have these worms in our system as much. So we've evolved over millions of years to deal with the fact that the worms suppress our immune system. We don't have the worms suppressing our immune system, and now our immune systems are overreacting to things they shouldn't. Later, when we talk about diseases, I'll talk a little bit about what that means, your immune system overreacting. But it's possible that our world is getting a little too clean and that we're not getting exposed to some of these worms when we're playing in the dirt as little kids. And that maybe that might be healthy for us to have a little bit of exposure. So this is the group of pathogens that we're trying to fight, and we have an amazing immune system that's going to take those on.